Hello. In this video, I will be introducing Unity Game Engine to all of you. So first, to open the Unity Game Engine, we have to open Unity Hub. We have to open Unity Hub and create a new project by clicking here. When we click New Project, we can see a window like this. Here, you can see the templates that can be used to create a project. You can also see the versions of Unity that have been installed by clicking up here. I will select the 2022 version from these options. I'm going to choose the 3D option as the template here. After that, I'm going to name this project Intro to Unity. I'm going to then create project here. We are going to have to wait a bit until the project is created, as all elements related to the project must be imported. What we see here is the Unity editor of the Unity Game Engine. This is the main interface of the Unity editor. There are a few key windows here that I will now tell you about. This is the hierarchy window. This is the scene window. This is the game window. This is the inspector window. These are the project and console windows below. You can see the game objects from our games listed in the hierarchy window. You can edit what is needed within the game in the scene window. What can be seen while playing the game and through the main camera in-game can be seen in the game window. The inspector panel shows the characteristics of any selected object. You can also add any other components you may need from here. Any custom scripts, audio components, or rigid body components can be added as components here. The project window can be used to see any project file that has been created on your hard disk, along with its contents. When you create scripts, they will be created in the assets folder within the project window. If we import any 3D assets, they too will be imported into the assets folder. There is a folder called Scenes that has been created within the Assets folder. You can also see a Unity scene called Sample Scene that has been created within the Scenes folder. This is the scene that we have switched on now. We can see that it's an empty scene. You can right-click here, select Create, and create as many scenes as you want by clicking Scene. I will first teach you how to create a 3D object in Unity. First, click the plus mark that can be seen in the hierarchy window. Select 3D objects from the drop-down list that is seen. They have provided us with a few options for primitive objects. I will select Cube from this list, which will add a cube to this scene window. You will also be able to see this cube added to the hierarchy window. When you click it within the hierarchy window, you will be able to see its characteristics within the inspector panel. You can move and look around within the scene window by right-clicking the mouse and dragging it. If you add any other objects into the scene window, they can be looked at by doing this. You can also right-click while clicking the WASD keys on the keyboard to navigate within the scene window. This makes it quite easy to edit details when creating complicated games using this software. You can also see a small panel here. This panel includes the View tool, the Move tool, the Rotate tool, and the Scale tool. These are the four tools that we most commonly use. We can use the View tool to drag the scene around to look at it. The Move tool can be used to move the selected game objects along the X, Y, or Z axis. You can see the position change on the inspector panel as you move these objects. When I hold the Z axis handle and move it, you can see the Z axis change. You can also do the same for the Y axis as seen here. The Rotate tool can also be seen here. The Rotate tool uses these handles to rotate the game object in any direction we want. We also have the Scale tool here. When you select the Scale tool, you will be able to see three handles on your selected game object. I will zoom in for you to be able to see better. By holding this small cube in the middle and dragging the handles back and forth, you will be able to completely change the scale of the entire game object. If you drag only the red handle back and forth, you will be able to increase the scale along the x-axis. You are able to change the shape from a cube into a cuboid and back. You can also do the same and increase or decrease the scale along both the Z and Y axes. You can also select the game object and change the scale on the inspector panel as shown here. I will create another 3D object. The second cube that we created was created on top of the first existing cube. We can use the Move tool while selecting the second cube in order to move it out of its original position so it can be seen. We can also navigate within the scene window using the method I showed you earlier. There are also three buttons here at the top. We mainly use the play and pause buttons. When we click the play button, we can play and try out the game that we have created. What we are viewing here is what can be seen from the main camera. When we create a new project, both a main camera and directional light are created automatically by default. What is seen in the game window is what can be seen through the main camera. I will drag the game window to the side and show you. If I move the main camera back and forth like this, what is seen in the game window is the view of the main camera. We can play this and try it out. When you play it, you can see the view in the game window. You can also use the pause button to pause it here. We are not going to use this step button now. We can use the play and pause buttons as I mentioned earlier. I hope that you learned something new from this video. Goodbye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. We're so glad that you joined us on the Render Island channel today. We're always creating new content for Unity developers, so please subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next one.